All right, week 22, cycle 3 in Orchestra. This might be my second to last video. I may just combine week 23 and week 24 in ways that we can review, because that's what we're doing from here on out. After you get past this lesson, we are just reviewing. So take a deep breath, relax, we're almost done. So this week we are talking about Stravinsky, Igor Stravinsky, and the Rite of Spring. And there's no question why CC chose this piece. It is just, we'll get there. We'll talk about that. So the vocabulary word this week is just bassoon. That's it. That's the only vocabulary word. It's because the Rite of Spring starts off with a bassoon. It gets like kind of the main part in the song. It has like a lot of solos and stuff. It's right here, a picture of it. I'm on page 194, like after you're done with orchestra. It's this instrument right here. It's in the woodwind family, and let me turn this around. In the woodwind family, it's a double reed instrument. So they'll play through here. The sound goes all the way down and back up out this way. So that's what instrument you're going to be hearing. That's a vocabulary word for this week. And I'm going to turn back to page 192 in our foundations guide and continue on. So that's your vocabulary lesson, is bassoon. You can talk about this separately, or you can talk about it later when you get to the piece. I'm just going to talk about it later when I get to the piece, when I go to do my lesson, but I just shared it with you now. So all right, so read your little paragraph here. It tells you a little summary about it. I'll just go ahead and cover that now. So Igor Stravinsky, it's very interesting. So he was born in Russia in 1882. Now, he actually was raised in a musical household. His dad was a bass singer, and his mom was like a really talented piano player. But they did not want him following in his footsteps for whatever reason. I do not know. But they did not want him following in his footsteps. They pushed him to study law. So he did. And while he's in college, he makes a friend. And his dad is a composer. So that composer kind of becomes his mentor, and he gets into music industry anyway. So so he starts composing. He did a few numbers before he did the Rite of Spring. So let me make sure I didn't forget anything here. No, that's pretty much it. So in 1913 is whenever he presented the Rite of Spring. And in your book, you'll see in Classical Conversations Foundations Guide, it says that it started a riot, which is true. It's just kind of exaggerated. What happened was, you know, they go into this ballet and it's new. Like, we went from the Romantic period to kind of the transition period with Debussy. And now we're like in the modern period. And this song is just, I don't know if you guys have heard it yet. It's just so different. I can totally see why people were unhappy about it. What happened was, it's like the bassoon starts off, everything's kind of fine, but then as it progresses, people start getting like really frustrated about this song, because it sounds like a cacophony to me. That's maybe that's why they were getting so upset. Basically, what ended up happening was people started like throwing vegetables at the orchestra and like booing them and jeering everything. And so I think like 40 people got like kicked out or arrested or something like that. So I guess it's a tiny riot. But I mean, this is how this is how different this song is. It's just, it just did not fit in with that time. But I guess some people like grew to love it, and I don't prefer this piece. I don't really like it. But musicians say like this is the most influential piece ever written, especially for that century. So all right, so back to Stravinsky. So World War I came around, and I think he had like a wife and 4 kids, so that pushed him to move to Switzerland. From there, I think he moved to France. His wife and his daughter died of like tuberculosis or something. Anyway, so he ended up coming to the U.S. in the 30s, 1939. He was living in the U.S. And then 1940s, he tried to rearrange the national anthem. He got a little bit of trouble for that, but otherwise all was well. And then he eventually died in 1971. So about this, that's just a little bit about him. You could look up more if you want and leave out what you want. You know, if you have little kids, maybe you don't want to talk about his wife and his daughter dying, but whatever you choose to talk about. So The Rite of Spring. So we start out with the bassoon. That's what I'm going to talk about, the bassoon, that it's a woodwind instrument, and show them a picture. And this piece just, it sounds very much like a cacophony, and talk about that with them because they learn that in Tin Whistle. So feel free to say that if you want. There's a few harmonized parts, but you could even ask them, like, doesn't this sound like a cacophony? Like, what does that mean? And you know, you could talk about it. So really for this piece, all I'm going to keep stopping and talking about is just talking to my class about like what instruments they hear. We've got flutes, clarinets, oboes, bassoons, violins. I mean, that's like the main instruments I'm going to be pointing out to my class. So I'll go ahead and start it now and I'll walk you through like a little bit of it. I don't want to do the entire song, especially this song. Listen to it a little bit. Some people, they listen to it for a while and they're like, oh, I kind of like it. I'm not one of those people. I'm not really a modern period classical music fan, but that's just me. So I'll go ahead and start this piece. So like I said, it starts off with the bassoon. It's nice and it's pretty and there's no problems in the very beginning. And then that's when we start, you know, about 30 seconds in, you start to realize like this is sounds kind of, I don't know what's going on here. And by a minute, you realize it just sounds like a cacophony. I don't know. It's just so different, but I'm sure a lot of people appreciate it. So, and I think Disney used this for Fantasia. I'm not sure, but, all right. So I'll go ahead and start that now. You can hear the bassoon in the beginning. If it's gonna pull up for me. That's the bassoon. It's playing very high. Still the bassoon, and then the English horn comes in. So that's the English horn that you hear. Not a very well-known instrument. So it was the bassoon first, and then the English horn. We start to, it to me, it starts to feel like we're getting a little bit into a cacophony here, but it's not as bad as it's gonna get. So at this point, we can stop and talk about the other woodwinds that we're hearing, some clarinets and some flutes. Maybe they'll recognize that and pick that out. Some flutes. So we also are going to hear some oboes and flutes right now. The oboe is similar to the clarinet. I think there's a picture of it in the book. So a lot of oboes and flutes going on right now. Thank you. basically all, there's some drums in the background, but these are basically right now, these are like all woodwinds playing. Like all of them, just all, they're all playing. So this is going to kind of crescendo really, really loud. And then when it gets quiet, you're going to hear the bassoon come in just like it's the beginning all over again. So listen for that. So these are violins being plucked. The violins are being plucked. Bump, 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 bump. You'll hear them. Now, at this point, the strings are going, and you can kind of stop and ask them maybe what they're feeling. You know, I kind of imagine, or what they're seeing, I'm sorry. I kind of imagine like a deer or a fox like, running away scared for its life, and the hunters are coming after it or something similar to that. So maybe you could ask them, like, what are you picturing right now? Or you could have them draw what they're picturing if they're drawing that day. Now we're going to have some trombones come in. I think it's, trombones. I can't remember if it's French horns. I'll listen and see. But trombones and some horns are going to come in. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and stop there, just like for the sake of time. You guys can keep listening to it, point out some crescendos, just stick to the basic vocabulary if you want. This is already a really hard piece if you're not familiar with music, so just stick to like what instruments you hear, maybe what they're imagining, some crescendos, things like that. Just stick to the basic vocabulary. And then after this, I'm going to play it again. They're going to draw what scene they're imagining when they're just listening to this. And then when we're done with that, I just go right into the orchestra song and they hold up their little instrument pictures while they do that. And that is really it. And like I said, when you are done with Igor Stravinsky, from here on out, it's just review. So you've gotten through the hardest part, introducing all of this. And then I'll just do another video. I'll try to combine week 23 and 24 together in just ways that I like to review. So let me know if you guys have any questions. I hope this video is helpful to you.